Hello! Bienvenue, Audrey Tautou in New York. Chérie.
Oh, thank you.
Do you remember when we met?
No, I don't remember.
It's a very long engagement.
And it was in New York?
It was in New York. And a very long engagement. That was your movie.
Yes.
That we were promoting.
Yes.
And I said, and you were taking pictures of all the journalists.
Yes.
And you said you were going to send me a picture. I never got it.
Yes.
Yeah, because there was only one camera.
I don't remember. It's been a very long time. It's like almost 6 or 7 years,
yeah,
right? So I have your picture somewhere.
Somewhere. Okay, so it's the Stephen Holt show, but anyway. So I loved your movie. So what's the correct pronunciation of her? Therese
Desqueyroux.
So let's tell us about that. That's a famous novel, and I never knew of it.
Yes, it's a very famous novel in France. It's a kind of classical literature, and it's written by Mauriac, Francois Mauriac, who's an amazing writer. And Claude Miller, the director of the movie, sent me the novel.
Just passed away. Yeah.
Yes, last year in April, sent me the book before writing the script, and it was a marvelous story and an amazing character. You know, very unexpected for me to, you know, have this kind of woman to act.
Right, because is she from a wealthy background herself at the beginning? Is she from a well-to-do aristocratic
She's
background?
From the, yeah, bourgeoisie. She's from the bourgeoisie in countryside in Bordeaux. And
is she marrying up to a more wealthy man?
No. It's not Slum more. No, it's not more wealthy, because actually she's richer than him. Mm-hmm. I mean, her family mm-hmm. is richer than he is. But, you know, it's all those very terrible conventions who force her to go into a life that she's not formatted for.
Mm-hmm.
I don't
mm-hmm.
know if I'm...
Format. She wasn't brought up for such a conventional life.
I mean, she was educated to have this kind of life, but she... Therese has a different nature, a different spirit, and I think she dreamed of living a life with independence, and she wanted to choose her life, but...
Because she seems happy at the beginning, and then she gets very restless.
Well, I think that at the beginning she thinks, she hoped that this wedding will rescue her, and this wedding will make all her ideas, which kind of poison her, stop, you know, and that she will become the good wife,
yes,
and like the other wife she can see in her surrounding. But pretty quickly she realized that she made a huge mistake, and that now she's in jail, and there's no way she can escape. That's a real nightmare for her.
Okay. Yeah, because it was like a Hedda Gabler a lot. It was just a play that, you know, about a wife trapped in the conventions of her marriage. And she doesn't...
Or Madame Bovary.
Oui. Exact. So she sees her husband has a heart problem. And she sees one night that he's taking arsenic. Is that right?
Yes, it was. Yeah, but it was a medicine
in those days.
In those days, and
he's counting out the drops one, and then she figures, Catherine sees.
Yeah, one day he thinks he didn't take his medicine, and she realizes that it's an opportunity to see what will happen if he takes a double dose, and after she's going to start to dive into the crime more. And yes and yeah but yes 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 yes
and
but I think that
she becomes a poisoner basically.
Yes, she becomes a poisoner because but it's a question of surviving.
She sees no other way out.
I think she doesn't see any other way. And also she has this curiosity of this crime, you know, the mystery of what will happen, what tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. I think she has she's also fascinated by what she's doing. She's scared but fascinated too, and also her hate for this family and this stupidity and this hypocrisy is growing so much. She hates that more and more and more, and it becomes very suffocating. So
very powerful performance. Very beautiful, powerful, but you're with her. You want her to
escape,
yes. Yeah. And I also loved you in the Coco Chanel movie, Avant Chanel, with Alessandro Nivolo, who's a friend of mine.
Okay.
So I'll say hello.
Oh, yeah, yes, yes,
we
definitely.
We talked about you a lot the year that film came out. We didn't get to talk, but I talked with Alessandro a couple of times. So, and Coco Chanel was a very different...
Formidable
in that, mademoiselle.
Thank you. But Coco Chanel was a... She was the same kind of character in the way that she's an avant-gardist.
Yes,
and she's ahead upon her time.
Yes,
and she wants to live her life with independence.
Yes.
Same as Therese, but the main difference is that Coco was a rebellion.
Yeah.
And she closed the door and she built her destiny.
Yeah.
And Therese is not a rebellious. She's,
yeah.
I mean, she doesn't have this. She's much more oppressed by the
society.
So she's an obedient woman.
Yes.
Even if she's a rebellious inside.
Very complex.
Yes, she's a very yes.
And,
she escapes only in her dreams.
Yes.
In her daydreams.
Let me just try one more time. Audrey Tautou in Therese Desqueyroux.
Desqueyroux? Yes.
Is it more O or U?
U.
U, Desqueyroux, oui.
Desqueyroux.
Bravo. Merci, merci, mademoiselle. Audrey Tautou here today on the Stephen Holt Show. Thank you so much.
You're
with
welcome.
A rendezvous with French cinema.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Yes.